Hello and good morning. President Donald Trump has continued his assault on the US electoral processes. In Uganda, President Museveni seems to be too obsessed with leadership. He does not care about democracy. And back home, the conundrum, the BBI conundrum, continues to place a strain on political friendships and political conversations. For this and more, welcome to Swali Edition. Today, the 12th of December 2020, happy birthday to me. I'm turning 27. Today is an amazing thing. I look older, but that's a story for another day. So, in addition, today we talk about three things: the continued assault on the U.S. electoral and justice system by incumbent President Donald Trump, who lost in the November elections by a huge margin. He lost by nearly 7 million votes, popular votes, and he lost 306 to 232 in the Electoral College. However, he has continued to attack the system, saying that it was fraudulent, and he won. Recently, he has sponsored, he has joined an electoral petition at the Supreme Court that has been sponsored by Texas Governor Mr. Paterson, which seeks to overturn the electoral results in Georgia, Pennsylvania, Nevada, and Arizona. The claims are the use of the electoral system used in those elections, the mail-in ballot electoral system used, as according to the Paterson, Mr. Paterson, the governor for Texas. The rights of Texans were contravened by the systems used in those four states. And he seems to be arguing that these electoral results should be overturned on the basis that those mail-in ballots were invalid. That's a strange argument. However, it's a claim that Mr. Paterson has his own needs. Mr. Paterson is under investigation by the FBI and other agencies for crimes, electoral crimes, and other financial crimes, and he seems to be seeking for leniency or pardons from the presidency. These are strange times. In Uganda, yesterday, the leading opposition to Yoweri Museveni underwent a very serious struggle. For nearly 5 hours, they were stopped by the police from going to their campaign scenes, and it was a strange thing because they had been stopped for those many hours. Then late at night, police dragged their vehicles to the bush, and the whole of the night, Bobby Wine and his team have slept in the bush, and some of them did sleep on trees. Just this morning, as he spoke to his team, he told them that the struggle is not about it's not about individuals, not about them seeking power. It's about them wanting to find a new Uganda for every citizen. And speaking to some of the people on the roadside who are asking him for tokens or some fine money, he clearly stated to them that the elections have been downgraded to a system of buying votes instead of the Ugandans voting for their leaders. In a strange turn of events, the Ugandan Communication Commission did crack down on foreign journalists, and just recently, three Canadian journalists were arrested and later deported. These are Canadian from Canadian Broadcasting Corporation, going further, the Communication Commission has also cancelled all licenses for foreign-based journalists, and they require that the journalist should not cover the elections. This sparked some outrage because immediately that happened, the U.S. reacted through its Foreign Affairs Office, stating that they are noting what is happening in Uganda, and as a big supporter of Ugandans and Ugandan systems, they'll take action. We don't know what action they'll take because it has been a casual approach to what the inhumane nature in which President Museveni is handling Ugandans at the moment. Closer home, there is a growing obsession with BBI, and last night the president has has indicated that he is himself going to lead the efforts to have a support for the BBI program, which is a strange thing. Yes, if this BBI is intended for what we are told, then we do not expect it to garner a lot of gerrymandering and antics. And we do not even want to hear stories from the other side that require there to be consensus. What is this consensus for? Strangely, while the battle out for the BBI for positions and influence in the BBI conundrum, there is the ongoing Msambweni parliamentary election by election, and there's been a strange turn of events where the president is supporting an ODM candidate while the deputy president is supporting an independent candidate. The deputy president has indicated that he'll be supporting a candidate fronted by some of his supporters from the coastal region. Closer home in Vihiga, yesterday the ECD teachers were officially unveiled, but there are still numerous concerns in the manner in which they were hired. These concerns have remained unaddressed. Some of them include fraudulent methods of hiring. Some of the ECD teachers who have volunteered for long periods of times were just dropped off the list of the hired teachers. It's strange, but we hope that the governor indicated that he will be making a follow-up to make sure that most of these teachers are taken. We hope that the county government can go the TSC way, where they ensure that these teachers who have not been put into formal employment, they also get to have an internship-based program. And we are hoping this time around it will be honest, and it will also be something that we can be proud about. Unfortunately, while we're seeking pride in these ECD teachers remain underpaid, and the salary scales for their salary scales are not well defined. We hope that these teachers will have clear, well defined salary scales, and we want, as we have earlier indicated, we want dignity in jobs. So these teachers should have jobs that are dignified, because they're handling the most crucial aspects of our community, the young kids. Lastly, on Swali Edition today, I'll take time to give myself a shout out. I just turned 27, and this is the 25th episode of the Swali Edition. For the last 57 years, Kenya has battled with its own challenges over and over again. When I started off Swali Edition a few months, some people have questioned the honesty or the ambitions of this program. Swali Edition is not about speaking. We're also making a lot of efforts to really follow up on some of the things we speak. We carry out a lot of petitions. We also face up with the organizations we feel should be making the right moves. So it's not all about talk and talk and talk. There is always something you are doing out there. And this is just to document our concerns. Thank you very much for staying with us. Have a lovely weekend. Godspeed.